Cinemachine 3 follow coming up. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hi everyone, this is Omar Bofiki and welcome to my game development and filmmaking channel. In this tutorial, we'll take a look at Cinemachine 3 follow camera. If you've checked the original Cinemachine series, you will remember that they were about controlling a player and then adding the camera on top of that. But here, to make things a little bit different, we're using a timeline and integrating Cinemachine to that. Here we have a simple scene, just a character walking, and we will see how we can add a camera to make it follow that character. First thing first, we just create a Cinemachine camera. We have it here. We can just call it follow camera. And then the first thing we need to do is assign the tracking target. So let's assign the character here. And it should be working, right? Well, no, not yet. We still have two fields we need to assign, or at least one of them. First, we have the position control and then the rotation control. For the position control, if we assign it to follow, it will be following the player, but it will be looking at a random angle maybe, or whatever rotation we had before. So we need to adjust it manually, and we hit play. And before we do that, make sure we are using the solo button here, the toggle, to make sure that we're seeing the correct behavior of the Cinemachine camera. So let's hit play. Okay, cool, we have it here. We can add Y offset and rotate it down. Interesting. And to make sure that the camera is looking at the player, we can add the rotation control, which is hard look at. Now, solo again. And yeah, the camera is looking at the player. If I modify any of the offset, you will see that it's still looking at the player. So that's pretty much it in the simplest and fastest way to add it. You can adjust the offset here. You can adjust the damping, which is the time it takes to follow the player. The bigger the number, the longer it takes to follow the player. The lower the number, the faster it is to follow it. So if I just set it to 0, as you can see, there is nothing smooth about it. It just snaps with the player as if it's attached to it. But if we increase it to 5, let's say, and I'm just gonna go halfway in the timeline, like it has a spring of some sort. So let's just put it back to 1 and let's make something interesting out of this. I'm just gonna pull the camera to the side here. Okay, and hit play. And we can just zoom and look, what do we have? That is very interesting. One thing we could do, let's say you want to have more control over other options, then you switch from follow to position composer, and for the rotation from hard look at to rotation composer. And look at how the different options we have here. But for now, let's not adjust them. Even we have damping for the rotation, which we didn't have before with the hard look at. But for the sake of the simplicity of this tutorial, I'll just use these two just to show you how with little we can do a lot. And in the other tutorials, we will explore the different type of cameras of Cinemachine. And this is not an ad, sort of. I'm just reminding you of my Unity Filmmaking 101 course. If you're interested in more filmmaking, camera stuff, timeline with Unity, remember to check out my Unity Filmmaking 101 course, where we dive into all of that and create a short film and a showcase video in less than 4 hours. And back to the tutorial. So let's add some spices to this. I'm gonna start animating these components. So I'm going to drag the follow camera here, add an animation track, hit the record button here, and I am going to start with this angle here, And as we move around, I want to pull it down like this. Just as simple as that. And maybe a little bit of zooming around. Yep. And to make it even more noticeable, just for the sake of this tutorial. Okay, let's see what we have. All right, that is really awesome. We could even go crazy and just make it start from this view, and we just stretch that last frame to the end. And let's look at this. I think this is cool, especially that we're using dynamic animation, which is Cinemachine, and no coding, nothing. And the only thing we did is just like two keyframes, and we had this amazing camera movement, which is incredible. So this is the end of this tutorial. I hope you like it. If you've got any questions, let me know in the comments below. And if you have time, remember to check out my Unity Filmmaking 101 course to use the power of real-time and Unity to create a short film. This is Omar Bofaki. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.